Continuing coverage now on the plans to bring a minor league basketball team to Santa Cruz. That project is moving forward despite not having the final green light. Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live in Santa Cruz with the latest. Phil?
Well, Dan, the agreement comes just a day before Tuesday night's public hearing about the project. The Seaside Company and the Warriors agreed to a 7-year deal that will provide $595,000 to the boardwalk for use of its site. The Golden State Warriors and the Seaside Company have been in negotiations for the use of this lot along Front Street since February. It's used by Boardwalk employees. In the agreement, they'll be shuttled to and from the River Street parking lot. The Warriors have also agreed to a sponsorship deal with the Seaside Company, which will allow the Boardwalk logo on center court.
It is something we wanted to do because we wanted to support the city in their effort to bring the Warriors to Santa Cruz. It's a big deal for Santa Cruz. It's great for the Boardwalk to have the Warriors here as well.
The Golden State Warriors have also agreed to strengthen its investment in the $5.4 million 7-year deal with the city. They'll prepay 4 years of rent on the temporary 30,000 square foot arena.
Both sides have fronted a lot of pre-development costs. The Warriors have paid for, you know, the sound study. We've paid for a certain amount of the parking and traffic management review that's been done. We are going to fund some incremental signage to help people understand how to get to and from the building.
The city also believes it reduces the city's overall risk by increasing security on the loan.
There's really three sources of funding. One is the city loan, which is at $4.1 million. The second is a cash contribution by the Warriors, which is at $1.6 million. And then DEFCON Construction is going to be putting in $100,000.
Meanwhile, residents in the Beach Hill area are prepared to bring their concerns to Tuesday night's meeting, which centers on parking, traffic, and noise issues.
The impacts are still real. The process has been rushed. We have no idea whether or not we'll get paid the money back that we're putting into the deal, and we haven't even seen the terms.
And the city's planning commission heard those complaints last week before giving its approval to the project. Dan?
All right. Thank you, Phil. Tomorrow night's public hearing begins at 7 at City Hall. The city then presents the financial and legal agreement for city leaders for their approval. Council has to okay a special use permit, too, for the property that's zoned for residential right now.